And George, when she was hitting the fairway too, it wasn't just like barely, it was like the middle of the fairway.
From New Zealand, please welcome Lydia Ko.
Very interesting approach considering that there isn't a ton of wind. You know, I see that sometimes when you want to keep it really low, but there's not a ton of wind out there.
A fairway finder for Ko. All three off to a good start with their opening tee shots. Settle in. It's Friday at the U.S. Women's Open. Third shot for Ko.
That is unbelievable.
Avoids a blemish on the scorecard somehow at the par 4 11th. Julia?
She's got an opening, really good angle into this hole in about 10 yards.
Oh my goodness, are you kidding me? Oh, that looked so thick too. I mean, it looked sticky. It looked.
And for the second straight hole, she escapes with a par.
And then it will kick slightly to the left, give you a great angle in. It's exactly what Brooke just did.
Really bend that left foot, and the key here was staying down the entire time. It's so easy to come up too quickly because of how awkward the stance is, but she did such an incredible job of really staying in her stance the entire time, staying low and just slamming that club face aggressively into the sand and creating. One of those go in after you miss a short putt in the previous hole.
She's got a 9-iron in her hand, 120, but up 8, slightly into the wind. She's looking to hit this 132. On a good line.
Really good shot.
Yeah, she was flirting a little bit with that front bunker, but really good aggressive play.
Ko pours that one in. Great bounce back birdie after bogeying the last hole.
The green is so far elevated above her as well, so she needs to get this high quickly. That's just so good.
Touch of class from Rose Zhang out of the bunker.
She just seems to be hitting right at it and just coming up short. And bunker shot. Really nice lie, so could take a much more conventional bunker swing at it.
Bunker cam taking some shrapnel.
You can just see how much sand she did take.
Zhang to scrape out a par.
So she can just hit something on the front portion of the screen and get it to run out there.
Exactly as you were breaking it down.
Fairly awkward stance. I mean, you can see how even just her body weight, she had to put more weight on her left foot, even just the dig mark in the sand, and ball well below her feet, which is easy to squirt the ball.
Zhang needs one positive strike with an iron to get some momentum going. This isn't it.
This is hanging right. Yeah, going where she was yesterday. Needs a good kick.
Let's go, Rose. Let's go. Got it. Result much better than the strike.
Downhill, left to right.
Zhang for birdie number one. First one today.
Really important for players to take a club that cannot get them to that left fairway bunker. It really widens the fairway up. They can almost take it much further left and almost directly at it. Ball below her feet, similar to her playing competitors. Wind in that, wanting to move it slightly right.
Best of the bunch.
Really well judged. You could also see her aiming spot there was, she did exactly where she aimed. She was planning for the ball to move a little bit to the right.
Ko's birdie effort finds the bottom of the cup.
Broke so much, like you said, Julia, but her pace was really good and took that turn and then put a little bit more spin on the ball and could fly it a little bit more aggressively. She hit that, and hit that hill, so kind of got up.
Pure roll.
Downslope, which I think will help her get the ball running. She has a ton of green to work with.
Inside the cut line at plus three. Aggressive line for Henderson.
Much better.
That is blasted past the other two tee shots. Fourth at the fourth.
That was well executed.
Zhang's third.
He's just so well judged, coming from above this hole. So impressive, and Lydia's now going over here just to give Brooke a little bit extra time. She had a good lie out of that rough and a great angle in. Moving slightly right to left on her, maybe. Really about the speed here.
Third one in four holes.
I was looking back at her putting stats. So 2014 when she started.
Lydia Ko, good amount of breathing room at plus three. Same goes for Rose Zhang. Is that plus two?
You know, the wind picking up, it's definitely making the golf course more of a challenge. And yesterday, even though there was that rain and that mist, it softened up the golf course a little bit. More space, a little bit more comfort. And then she
can shot.
Either chip or, if she gets lucky, have it reach the green. Oh, that was the perfect club.
Great shot from Henderson.
Here's Henderson's hybrid. She fortunately went with a shorter club that ended up being absolutely the perfect yardage landing.
Zhang birdie attempt.
So difficult, such a tough lie. To even get it up out of that, over this bunker, so impressive.
She landed that in the perfect spot. a foot or two shorter, and that's potentially standing her off. A couple feet further, it hits that downslope and roll past the pin. Her world-class short game has been on full display in this second round.
Lydia has a sand wedge in her hand. 107, down 10, downwind. Looking to hit this about 85 yards.
Oh, I was talking about the big bounces. That got to stop so quickly. Now, Julie, I know they were given a warning.
Uses all of the cup.
And it was just slow enough to catch that corner and drop in.
You also know how it's going to come out of a bunker. You can predict how it's going to come out based on your lie. With a shot like this, you're just kind of hitting and hoping.
Hope it goes in.
It's really small, grip really down on the club. And jabbed it out of that rough.
Good one from Henderson.
Perfect for us.
Three really good tee shots to end their round. You can see how much, though, that fairway really kicks to the right, because Lydia's looked really center and it just kept funneling down. Really good effort. And those irons that she was missing, Bird, just looking at her swing, there's nothing that stood out to me that she was doing something like tempo was off or she was doing something mechanically. It really just looked like she was not hitting the correct yardages, whether that was the wrong club choice or just wasn't hitting them as full as she was really supposed to. Now, considering some of the spots she had put herself in early in the round, one under is just really good. It was like a Houdini in some places where she was getting up and down from.
'76-'71, Lydia Ko will be around to see the weekend. '71 on Thursday, '75 on Friday.